Give it up for Peaches Christ!
Let's hear it for Jackie Beat, everybody! Our master of ceremonies here tonight at the Roast of Heklina. You know, Heklina is, of course, the star of the roast, but Jackie is clearly its biggest target. You know, Jackie's gotten so fat that the only airline that would fly her to San Francisco was SpaceX. They both have the same slogan, "We've blown up a bit." It's Sister Roma, everybody. That's right. Sister Roma is, of course, one of San Francisco's most legendary queens and perhaps its most legendary cocksucker. It's true. Everyone knows Roma goes down faster than Morgan McMichaels in All Stars 3. She doesn't lip sync. She doesn't really act. She's really not a comedy queen. I recently did a show in Fort Lauderdale starring Latrice Royale called Mr. Act. That's right, it's about a nun who was addicted to drag, and it was so fun. I'm thinking of a sequel this year starring Sister Roma. It would be called Mr. Act 2, Back in the Habit. And it's just a documentary about Roma relapsing on meth. She was a meth addict. It's true. Roma loves meth so much, Katya considers her her biggest influence. Speaking of influences, Julie fucking Brown is here. I want to pause so everyone under 50 can Google you for a moment, but I mean, okay, here it is. You had a show on MTV that was amazing. You were a guest on The Tonight Show, and of course you were in Clueless and Earth Girls Are Easy. I mean, that's pretty impressive. The biggest claim to fame any of the rest of these queens have is, well, Jackie's claim that she invented Drag Race. Yes, it's true. Jackie says RuPaul stole the idea of Drag Race from her. Yet she'll tell anyone who'll listen that the show is ruining the spirit of drag. Oh, please, Jackie. You aren't upset that Drag Race is ruining drag. You're upset that you aren't getting any of the credit and money. You complain about being overlooked more than milk. You're like old milk. But you're not big and milky, you're big and sulky. Even Thor G. Thor is like, girl, you need to let things go, okay? Speaking of getting fucked, Alaska, everybody. Alaska reminds me of the state because she's cold, she's been full of bears, and old white men will pay a lot of money to drill deep inside her. But Alaska, you're a star, you know it. Watching Alaska perform, you know she can just feel it in her bones. Also, you can literally see her bones. Alaska's the only queen up here who can legitimately claim to be skinny. And for that, Alaska, I say, fuck you and the horse face you rode in on. You know, Alaska reminds me of that old joke. A horse walks into a gay bar, and the bartender asks, why the long face? And the horse replies, hi. People say having sex with Alaska is like having sex with Seabiscuit, because it feels like a race and she always finishes first. Plus, you look like a horse. And finally, you guys, you know this one. What does a gay horse eat? Hey! Right, but in Alaska's case, it's cum. Alaska did have time this year to appear on a different VH1 reality show where reality stars competed to see who could live in a haunted house the longest. It was called Scared Famous, which is ironic because they were neither scared nor famous.
Jinx Monsoon! Jinx is here, who confirmed to the world this year that she's non-binary because she's a millennial and she doesn't want to be labeled. I think that's great. And Jinx, you should feel comfortable being whatever it is you want, which increasingly appears to be a drunk Ginger Minj impersonator. Jinx has gained some weight recently, but actually I see it as a very, very clever career move, because that way, Jinx, no matter how famous Bindle Krim gets after All Stars, you'll still be the biggest queen in Seattle. You guys, it's just business. Big business. It's so nice to be here to roast my best ghoul friend and drag partner, Heklina, a legend of drag, ladies and gentlemen. And I've heard you queens talk about how fat and ugly and talentless she is, but as her dear friend, I just want to say you're completely wrong. She is not fat. Jackie's fat. I'm fat. Heklina is just totally, oddly fucking shaped. Okay, look at her. She has a gigantic head, a compressed, distended torso, and thick, slumpy legs. She's like a plus-size Peter Dinklage. But she's not fat, okay? And how dare you say she's ugly? That face isn't ugly. Look at it. It's original. It belongs in a museum. A natural history museum, sure, but still a museum. And then how dare you come for her talent? You know, Heklina's been a drag innovator for decades. She created Tranny Shack, the drunken launching pad of drag queens worldwide. She opened the drag bar Oasis and was the first queen to incorporate live rim jobs into her act. Between all the drunk performances and rim jobs, Heklina has eaten more shit while performing than a German porn star. She's eaten more shit than six girls, three cups. So how dare any of you come for her at all? She is a goddamn legend! And with that, I just want to close by saying it is true that we've been friends since 96. Roma, Heklina, and I have known each other that long. I love you so much. You're the funniest person I've ever met. And I don't know what life would have been like without you or Tranny Shack. So thank you, honey.